He said there ain't no rest for the wicked. Money don't grow on trees. I got bills to pay, I got mouths to feed. There ain't nothing in this world for free. I know I can't slow down, I can't hold back. Though you know I wish I could. Oh no, there ain't no rest for the wicked until we close our eyes for good.
Everybody, back again. Kind of skipped ahead on you guys a little bit and started forging the guards. I'm going to pick up where I am at the moment, which is where I've just shaped four basic horse head shapes on either side of both the top and bottom guard. Now we're going to actually start turning those into guards, fitting them up on the sword, then we can start actually customizing our horse heads.
The next day.
So it is now the next day, and this is where we are. We've got our front guard up here, which still needs to get fit up. It's a little loose at the moment, but that's going to have those two horse heads. And we've got down here on the base the beginnings of a crown that's going to be mounted on top of these horse heads. And then this tang is going to get split, and these are going to act like two parts, a rivet and a loop. So this will be semicircular or ovate on the back end of the sword. Still got a lot of polishing to do before heat treat, a lot of grinding to do before heat treat, trying to get that blade nice and shiny, get rid of all those hammer marks. So I'm gonna keep at that for a little while, and then we'll be back to work on the horse heads and clean up those guards some more and work on that crown. So I have got the blade as polished as I'm gonna be able to get it before heat treat. There are a couple of little black spots still on there. I've got the bevels ground. It's got about a millimeter, if that, worth of edge. So let's get it heat treated. I'm gonna quench this, and then I'm gonna go get it tempered. So we ended up with a nice straight blade out of the quench. Get you guys a look at this. It's still wiggling from when I put it in the vise. But yeah, got a nice straight blade. Skating that file beautifully. While that cools and while that's getting tempered, I'm gonna work on all of our guard fittings. What I'm gonna do is polish up these horse heads on these guards here, get these nice and shiny, and then we'll whip out the Dremel tool and some files and start working on the detail work. So now we have gotten the blade polished all back up after heat treat. Got it nice and shiny. We've got our guard fittings all polished up too. Now we're gonna go over to the vise and I'm gonna show you guys how I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna take a file and I'm gonna deepen these striations on this crown and bring them down to that line I created. So we've got our grooves extended down to that line, and we've also brought them up towards the center for that crown. Now I'm just going to go over to the belt sander and we're going to polish this up a little bit more. Now we've gone ahead and gotten those all polished back up, all shined back up for our little crown here. It's going to seat itself right here on top of these horse heads at the end of the tang, and then I'm going to split that tang with a grinder. And we're gonna loop that tang back around to form a semicircular shape on the base here. So that's gonna be during assembly. Right now I'm gonna actually stick the horse heads that I finished shining up back in the forge, and I'm going to put some detail work on the horse heads, kind of give them some facial features, and then we're gonna hit them on the grinder and the Dremel tool again, so that way they can get all polished up and look good. I was mainly knocking off all the scale from the initial shaping because that formed a lot of scale, and forming the faces shouldn't form as much scale as what I was doing before. So let's get these dealt with and then we'll move on to the next step. So we've done the fun stuff, now it's time for difficult and crazy stuff. We've gotten our horse head guards all ready to rock and roll. They just need to be heat fitted into place. This will be held on here by these two flanges that I just created. I just took my grinder and ripped that. I don't know how well you're gonna be able to see it, but I ripped it down to right about here, just below that shoulder where this sits. So that way when I do bend this out and scroll it over, it's going to hold this on as well as actually bending and locking down the handle. Just need to get these heat fitted into place. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw these in the forge, and we're gonna start heating these up and popping them in where they belong. Out of the forge now, and as you can see, this is all assembled. We've got the base down here. These loop backs both hold this crown in place and hold the horse heads in place on that guard, so none of it'll go anywhere, and it provides a really cool bottom guard piece, kind of very aesthetic. You've got the crown with the horses, and then you've got these big ovate shapes on top of that holding down onto it. Then you've got your nice simple top cross guard there. So we are making some progress on this thing. All that's left to do is start polishing, grinding the edges a little more, making them a little sharper, polishing up all the guards, and then the handle. We're only going to get as far as finishing the actual handle and the assembly today. The next video will be the cut testing, and that will be wild because I can anticipate this thing is going to be a wicked cutter. Just figured I'd give you guys a little closer look before I do the polishing. So this was a socket. I might have gone over that already, or I might not have. And then all the rest of it is coil spring. Even the guards and everything was coil spring on this blade. So fits in the hand just so. Once we get the handle on there, it's gonna be leather. It's gonna be real pretty.
3 hours later.
So we have gotten our small sword all finished up. The only thing that's left to do is put the final edge on this beautiful little blade, and then we will test it in the next video. So this is going to be where we stop for this video. It's been a long project. It took me about 3 days to do everything. So handle, blade, guard fittings, all that stuff. It's about a 3-day project. And I'm very happy with how this turned out. All I gotta do is put a real sharp edge on this before we test it, and it's gonna be a heck of a cutter. Our point of balance is beautiful. It's only a few inches off the actual guard itself. And as you can see, it's still a little handle heavy there. So that makes me very happy. It's a very light, fast sword. It's thicker at the point, so that way when it's thrusting, it doesn't have to worry about getting damaged to the point. You find this on some historical small swords. Just gives them a little more strength But yeah, if you guys like what you've seen, go ahead and hit like, subscribe, all that jazz, and don't forget the bell icon so you can see this get tested against water bottles and a bunch of other fun stuff. So that way I can show you guys how well this cuts for how crappy of a swordsman I am. Until next time, God bless. Stay sharp out there. And if you're looking for a custom blade, check out the Etsy store. Link at the end of the video. Thank you.